you've found yourself in Panama City, which is not so weird, considering that it is home to the Panama Canal. It connects travel, business, commerce. It's also known as a world city because of all the people that happen to stop by there on their way to their travels. If you do find yourself in Panama City, then I definitely recommend taking a few days to explore because there is definitely a lot to do. Because of this, I'm going to help you out and give you my top 7 things to do in Panama City. Let's go. Take a tour of the different versions of Panama City. Yes, there are different versions. You can start off your tour by visiting the ruins of the old Panama City, also known as Panama Viejo. This is the original Panama City, and in the 1600s, there was an attack on the city, and there was this huge fire, and it pretty much destroyed all of Panama City. After the city was destroyed, they made a brand new Panama City not too far away, and that Panama City is now called Old Quarter Panama City, or Casco Viejo, and it is now the historic district of the new Panama City that was built after the original Panama City, but it's not really the new Panama City. So that leads us to modern day Panama City, which is the one that most people think about, which has all the skyscrapers and crazy beautiful modern day architecture. This is an awesome first day activity that you can do when you land in Panama City. It's not something that will take a very long time. You can do just a one day tour and be able to see the architecture and the evolution of the city. The way that I did this was through tourism full service. They were super awesome and really nice and were able to explain to me the whole history of Panama City and took me to all of these different sites, and it was a really personal experience, and I would definitely recommend them if you're able to book a day tour with them. So that's tourism full service. Links for everything will be down in the description below. Any extra information will also be there, so definitely check it out after you're done watching this video. Get as close to paradise as possible with the San Blas Islands. So you're gonna have to take a little bit of a journey to get to the San Blas Islands, but there are plenty of tours available to help you do this. The San Blas Islands are over 300 islands of just beautiful, crystal clear, blue water, untouched land that is home to the Kuna Indians. And because of this, the islands are also called the Gunayala Islands. And pretty much the only people who live there are the tribes people. And they open up some of the islands for people like us to come and visit and be able to experience living on a deserted island or just having fun in paradise and relaxing and just enjoying this wonderful gift of nature. There are a few options for the San Blas Islands. You can either stay there for a few days. They actually have places for you to camp there. I decided to just do a day trip. My time in Panama City was limited, so that is also an option if you feel like you do not have enough time to go and stay there and, you know, have this whole deserted island experience. You can do a day trip, and it is still really worth it, and I had an amazing time, and it was very relaxing and beautiful, and I definitely recommend, if you have a few days in Panama City, find a tour and visit the San Blas Islands because you will not regret it. Go where the two oceans meet. The Panama Canal. I know, this is so typical. Everybody says you gotta go to the Panama Canal, but honestly, you're in Panama City, and this is a cultural experience to be able to see the construction behind the Panama Canal. And if you are able to go there early in the morning and just wait for the gates to open to see the process of the ships going through, it's really something that is so impressive. If you have the opportunity, then definitely do not let this slide just because it's like the common thing to do. It's really a cool thing. There is actually a museum there as well that will explain to you the process of the Panama Canal and the technicalities and mechanics behind it and how everything works and how all the trade routes are connected. It's really fascinating and informative. So I definitely recommend that be one of your stops in Panama City. Go on a culinary adventure. You're in Panama City and you get to explore and try traditional Panamanian food. There are so many options in Panama City to do this, and you can try rice, fried plantains, sweet plantains. They have a tamale in casserole. They have meat pies. There's so many delicious dishes and meals that you can have in Panama City. So definitely explore your taste buds and try to go on a culinary adventure. Ask around, find some traditional restaurants because the food is delicious and I am missing it right now. Have a personal encounter with wild monkeys. If you book an excursion to check out Monkey Island, you will be delightfully surprised by how close you can get to these wild monkeys. And it's so cool to be able to see them in their natural habitat. And if you love animals, this is an experience that you will absolutely just fall in love with. Getting to Monkey Island will not take too much time out of your day. The tour that I went with was super friendly and I was able to give little pieces of bananas to the monkeys, and it was really cool, and it's definitely something that you might not be able to experience anywhere else. But just be careful, these are wild animals, so keep your distance, be very aware of what is going on when you go, because you never know how they're gonna react. I got attacked a little bit by the monkeys, but it was still a nice experience, but definitely be careful if you do decide to do this. This next activity might turn off a few of you because it involves going to a museum, but before you give up on this video, hear me out. This is a very special museum. It is the Biodiversity Museum of Panama City, also known as Biomuseo, and it is designed by Frank Gehry, and it is inspired by the rainforest and the culture of Panama City. The museum mixes natural history with a vision of what the future will be. The way that it's designed makes it very entertaining to learn and grasp the information. And the architecture of the museum itself is just so beautiful and innovative. It's a really cool stop. The last activity that I am going to recommend to you is a little bit more immersive, visiting one of the tribes that live in the Panama City outskirts. So I had the pleasure of visiting the Wonan tribe. It is really cool to be able to see how the natives still live there and how they use the plants for medicinal purposes and for food, and being able to learn about the plant life and the purposes of each plant was really cool to me. I'm a huge nature buff and I love learning all that kind of stuff. And on top of that, they use the materials that they find in nature in order to handcraft things like bowls and jewelry. And if you happen to stop by one of these tribes, you do have the opportunity to buy any of their handmade things. I bought this bracelet from the Wonan tribe and I really like it. It's cool and it's just a really interesting experience. So if you are able to find a tour that can take you into one of the tribes, that's also something that I would recommend doing. Those are the things that I recommend you do if you find yourself in Panama City. If you want to see the full videos of my experiences in Panama City, then check out the playlist that is down below. I will also link it somewhere over here. So check out those videos because they will show you a more immersive experience of what these activities are like. And if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up or an upvote if you are on VidMe. And And definitely subscribe if you haven't already to get more travel tips from me. And follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. I am at Red Romina everywhere. Thank you so much for watching. Leave me a comment down below letting me know if you are planning to go to Panama City anytime soon. And if you're not, let me know where you are headed next. I want to know your travel plans. For now, I'm gonna go. So I will see you when I see you. Bye. This video was made possible by my patrons over at patreon.com/redromina. If you like what I do, become a patron and be a part of the exploration.